Guys, welcome back. So today I wanted to play around with one of my new LA Girl eyeshadow palettes. It came out a little while ago, maybe a couple of months ago or something like that, but I'm just now getting around to playing with mine. It's one of their hot heat eyeshadow palettes, and there was two, I believe, in this grouping that I bought. One of them is kind of like blue toned, and this one is more of like the purple and mauve-y tone one. So this is what she looks like inside. As you can see, there's a mirror in there, but these are the colors in this palette, you guys. Very pretty. I had a lot of fun creating this purple look today. Let me just show you a little bit closer. So this is what this palette looks like. As you can see, there's some beautiful shimmers in there, gorgeous mattes, and you can really create a beautiful mauve-y or purple eyeshadow look. You can do something smoky, something basic, kind of everyday neutral, but it's a gorgeous range of colors, and I think it performed fairly well for me. I think for a drugstore or, you know, a lesser expensive brand, it performed very well. Now these eyeshadow palettes, y'all know the drugstores is getting out of hand with their pricing, okay? Now, at the time that I purchased these, they were like sold out everywhere. And then Ulta had some, so I went ahead and picked some up from Ulta. And I know they were sold out like at the different CVS's and stuff for a while. But looking on the LA Girl website, it looks like they restocked on their website. So I do see them on there for 18 bucks. I think I got mine for about 15 from Ulta, but it's not on there currently. So this is what this one looks like. Let me go ahead and jump into some swatches for you, and then what I want to do is I want to give you a few alternative palettes just in case you like these colors and you're thinking you might already have a palette that has some of these colors or this tone in them. I'm gonna swatch some other palettes for you guys too. So let's swatch this one first. For this palette, you guys, as you can see, it has some beautiful shimmers, just absolutely gorgeous. I will say that some of the shimmers are kind of chunky to me, which I don't really mind that, because sometimes when they're chunky they pop a little bit brighter, but they can be a little bit messy and crumbly, but I like them. They're very pretty. The mattes are just like basic mattes, nothing to write home about. They don't swatch that great, but I didn't have any issues with them on my eyes. They blended out nicely. I did have to build them up a bit, but for a drugstore palette, that's kind of what I expect. Even though, like I said, they're getting a little crazy with these prices. But let me just go ahead and I want to swatch a couple of other mauve-y tone palettes for you, just in case, you know, you're wondering if you have some of these colors already in your collection. So I have this cute little Wet n Wild palette here, and it's called Roses in the Air, and they came out with these little palettes, I think maybe a couple of years ago, with just basic themes to them. And this one is, like I said, Roses in the Air. So let me just swatch a few of these so you can see what I mean about it basically having like the same tone to it if you already have this palette in your collection. So as you can see, this palette has kind of like that same berry theme. The only thing with this palette is that it doesn't have those beautiful shimmers in it, so you would be missing out on those. Now, another palette that I have in my collection that has a bit of a kind of purple or berry tone to it is this Element of Surprise from ColourPop. Now, this palette is beautiful. I mean, the shades in here are absolutely gorgeous, and the name really fits it, because when you look at this palette, it doesn't really look like a whole lot, but this palette does pack a beautiful punch. So let me just show you a few swatches from this palette. Thank you. this palette does have some actually really, really pretty shimmers in it as well. So these are some of the swatches from this palette. If you already have this palette in your collection, then you might not want to try and get the LA Girl palette. Now, another palette that I have in my collection that I just purchased actually is this Milani Gilded Rouge. I have played around in this a little bit, still trying to kind of figure it out and see what I do and don't like about it. But the colors in this palette are really, really pretty as well. As you can see, there's some of those plum shades, purple shades, along with also some blues and golds. Really, really pretty colors. So let me swatch this for you as well. So as you can see, this palette has some of the same feel as far as the colors and the tone of the palette as well, with the berries and the purples and the beautiful shimmers. So this is another palette where if you just purchased this, because this is one of their newer palettes and you're kind of thinking about the LA Girl one, you might not really need it because you have some of the same tones of shadows in this palette as well. Now lastly, I have this BYS Berries 2 eyeshadow palette. I did pick this up from Amazon quite a while ago, and I really, really fell in love with the color scheme in this palette because it has the nice, beautiful, deep berry shades. So you can create beautiful berry tone looks, smoky looks. It has a black and a silver in here and some beautiful shimmers. So let me go ahead and swatch this one for you. So these are some of the swatches from the Berry palette. As you can see, the same basic tone and feel to it with some pretty, pretty shimmers in there as well. Now this palette, I think I probably only paid about $9.99 or something like that for it on Amazon. So I know it's not that pricey. Or if you already have it, then you have a berry tone palette already. So I just wanted to share some different options for you guys in case you're not able to get your hand on this LA Girl Hot Hot Heat palette, because I know if you are a makeup lover or maybe a collector like I am, you already have a lot of these shades already in your collection. So with all that being said, let's just go ahead and jump into this look that I created for you guys today.